Hi guys, this is Saurav. In this video, we will learn how to code for AI app. In the last tutorial, we have learned how to design the AI app. And in this video, we are focusing on block section, how we code. Okay, so let's start. So first we need some extension here. So what we need, so first we need text to speech. Okay, so here you can see text to speech in a media. So drag and drop this one, like here. This one is non-visible component, and we have to drag and drop one more thing, speech recognizer. But the thing is, if I am using this one, so there's a one branding of Google, you know, like there's, you can see the dialogue of Google. So I don't want this. So what I'm going to do here, you can see I'll give you the link of this extension here. Here the extension community app builder.com, and that one is voice recognizer extension without Google dialog. So here you can see that one is extension here. So click on this extension AIX file and download this, and we have to go to the extension and you will see import extension and drag and drop this and import it, and you will see here the extension, right? And drag and drop this extension like this. Now I'm going to drag and drop this one two times, like again. So that one is recognizer one and recognizer two. Fine. Now I'm going to the block section here. Okay, we have to drag and drop one cloud DB also, because we have to store the data, right? Now I'm going to use one block, go to the storage and drag and drop cloud DB. First I'm going to focus on ask me button. For we are going to code for ask me button. Okay, so what we will do, click on this ask me button. You will see here button one. So I'm going to change this button name something ask me btn, that's the button name here. And for the teach me, I'm going to change this button name teach me btn, like this. Fine. And that one is manual btn. Fine. Go to the block section here. Okay, so we have to write the code for btn, and you will see here btn button ask me btn. So drag and drop this button here. Now that one is the, I'm going to make it, okay, there's one thing, just right click and you will see here like this how it's expand, and like this, and make it collapse. So okay, so it's better, you know, that's the code, that code. Okay, so whenever someone click on ask me button, so we have to display the voice recognizer. So what we will do, SC speak recognizer, so you will see here call get text. Okay, so whenever we ask, this will call, but this will not showing you the dialog box. Okay, now second thing, what we have to do this, like whenever we get the text. Okay, so click on speech recognizer one, and you will see here after getting text. So what we will do, whenever we get the text, so we have to call cloud DB to fetch the data. This tag is available or not, it means that question is available or not. If someone is asked what is the capital of America or what is the capital of India, so this tag, the Ellie will find the question first, it is available or not. If it is available, then she will give you the answer, otherwise she will not give you the answer. So now the thing is, what we will do here, we have to call the cloud DB because she will find the answer here. You will see get value here, right? Drag and drop this. And which tag we have to find, we have to find the result. It means if I have asked like what is the capital of India, it means that the result here, what we have asked, to get tag and value. If there is no value or in of this tag, we will just write here, that's the text, like this, and we just type here, I don't know, please teach me, I don't know, please teach me, like this. Fine. But if the answer is correct, so what we will do, first we have to set the value what we have asked in the label, so no one will confused. Okay, Now we have to set level 2, like you can see in our design, that's the question and that's the answer. So what we have asked, so we have to display this question also, because sometimes there's a problem with pronunciation. So we are going to drag and drop here, set label text, what we have asked, we will clarify with this, okay. And we have to set here what we have asked, that's the question or answer. It means first label is question, label 1 is for question, and that one is answer. It means what we have asked, it means the get result, set label. So whenever CloudDB dot got the value, it means call here CloudDB, and you will see here data change first got value, then we have to call. Here you will see text to speech, and we will call here like this, and we have to, you know, Ellie should speak the answer, Ellie should tell the answer. So which answer she will tell you, the answer should be the value, like what we have what we got from the CloudDB. It means first thing what we have done after getting text, we get the result tag. It means if the tag is exist, like what is the capital of India is exist, then we get the answer of this tag. Okay, so what we will get, so what we will get to get the value, so we have to get value like this here. Fine, now we have to set this value tag in a label. So just copy and paste this label like this here, and make this one is value, copy and paste it like this. Fine, and we have to change the label, so this one is going to be label 2. Fine, now what we have to do, so that's the ask for asking. Okay, so we have to store the value, because if she doesn't know something, so we have to teach her. Okay, so in this section we are going to teaching her. So first I'm going to teaching her manually, and the second part we will teach her like a in a voice, using voice. Okay, so first we teach by the manual, like in the second part you can see here. I'm going to hide this one, make it invisible and make it visible, right? This whenever someone click on the manual button for teaching her. So you will see here two text box, one is for question and second one is for answer, and that's the save answer button. I'm going to rename this button save answer btn. Okay, go to the blog, and you will see here the save answer button, where is it, this one. So whenever someone click on save answer button, so we have to store the tag, so we have to store tag, and then we have to store answer also, like question and answer both. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use here CloudDB 1 dot store value. You will see here the store value, like see, drag and drop this. And which tag we have to store, it means question, question is a tag, so that one is text box 1 value. So go to the blog, text box 1 dot text, this one is going to be our tag, and for this tag which value we have to store, text box 2 dot text, like that one is, here is the question and that's the answer here. Fine, we have stored the value. Now what I'm going to do here, we have stored the value here. Okay, now the thing is, we have to go to the design section and make sure this should be visible off, and this vertical arrangement should be visible on. Okay, make sure do this thing. Now we are going to test this app. Go to the campaign here and run AI. I'm using an AI campaign. So that's the app here, what we have built till now. If I'm asking something, like click on ask me button. Are you happy?
I don't know, please teach me.
She doesn't know. Like, see, that's the question, are you happy? And that's the answer. Now, she don't know, I'm going to teach her, click on manual. And I'm going to type here, are you happy? And here is the answer, like, yes, I'm so happy. Okay, and click on save answer. Now back button and ask her again. Are you happy?
Yes, I'm so happy.
Okay, so we had now the third button, teach me, by without writing the question and answer, right? So we will do this in the next video. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any doubt or if you have any like suggestion to improve this video and this app, so we will implement this idea. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like my video, subscribe my channel. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.